Hello, good morning. I am pulling out now to drive to the office to do the day's business. I know that if you work for government or working for another person, you should be in the office by now because it's after 9, actually 9:20 by my own watch. I don't know if it's GMT time. All right, so I wish to welcome you to this day, Friday, the 18th day of May 2018. Just 13 days remaining, and we shall be bidding goodbye to May. Okay? If you are a follower of mine, or a fan, or my friend, then you would have seen my post this morning on my timeline about the topic we discussed today, which has to do with being present while living or practicing mindfulness. There's a story that's following that post. It's about a 10-year-old girl who is suffering from cancer and who, in the past 3 years, has passed through 14 surgeries. 10-year-old girl. And yet, when you see her, you would never know that she's sick because she's always very lively, always wanting to play with friends and family. Always making plans. In fact, she says she has made plans for 2019. You can imagine that. 10 years. Then how about you as an adult? You know, every morning you wake up and you hiss as if you are annoyed to be awake. Instead of thanking God for life, instead of being enthusiastic about living, you are angry, you are annoyed, you carried over the challenge of yesterday into today, to this morning. And instead of thanking God and say, "I thank God, though I am able, I am awake, I am alive," you hiss, you worry, you grumble, you complain. That's all you do. And then you're asking for God to bless you. Haven't you seen, haven't you heard, haven't you known that when the people of Israel complained, God took it personally? He said that they complained against him. They didn't have the faith that he was going to help them, that he was going to do the things he promised to them. And so they complained. So each time you complain, you're actually making God a liar. Why? Because he has promised you that no matter the circumstance or situation, he will never leave you alone. He has promised you that no matter what you're passing through, he will always be there to carry you. He has promised you that he won't allow you to carry more load than you can afford to carry. So whatever load you're carrying, he has allowed it to happen because he knows you have the capacity and the capability to carry it. So instead of complaining, thank him. Thank him. Instead of murmuring, grumbling, appreciate him. Because those who are dead would give anything to be around here and even carry more load than you're carrying. But unfortunately, they are not here again. And if you also know that more than 2 million people die every night all over the world, then you will be happy that you are amongst the selected to be alive. So if you are fond of complaining, if you are fond of murmuring, if you are fond of grumbling, today put a stop. Put a stop. Final full stop. Stop. Okay, so that's my message to you this morning. It's done. You can see I'm driving. I'm on the road and I'm videoing this so that I can broadcast it to you. I wish you can also share it to your friends. Complaining, murmuring, grumbling, those are the negative aspects of mankind. We can do more if we stop complaining. We can do more if we stop grumbling. We can do more if we stop murmuring. Channel your energy to making your life better than it is at the moment. All that you need to do anything you want to do is already in you. If you didn't know that before, know it now. All that you need to do anything you want to do is already deposited in you. Find it. Don't go and wait for somebody to come and, you know, visionize it for you. Use your own. Number 6, find it. And when you find it, you'll see your life will change. I found mine years ago, tens of years ago. And I thank God I am living it. So find yours. If you are living a life you are not happy about, that is not your life. Find your own life and start living it. But do away with murmuring, do away with grumbling, do away with complaining. So it's Friday. It's the last working day of the week. Well, if you work for another. Because if you work for yourself, there's no last working day in the week. Every day is a working day. Alright? But however, it's Friday and it is the beginning. Well, it is the Ehabinga of good news of the weekend. It brings us the news that by tomorrow, Saturday, God willing, we will have to stretch our legs, relax our hair, and be alive, even for that day. All right, so let me allow you, maybe you're in the office, or maybe you're going to your place, as I am doing right now. Let me allow you to have a quiet moment. I will see you again in the evening, as I used to do. So have a nice day, and this Friday evening, remember to, you know, meet me up there, 1759, my Friday happy hour. I'll see you then. Enjoy.